Afternoon, YouTube. Welcome to my channel. My name is Leon. I'm Sulukulu. For everybody else who's already subscribed to the channel, thank you for subscribing. You don't have to subscribe to this young, handsome boy channel, but you do. Anyway, if you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe. If you like the video, hopefully you do. Grow the channel. I mean, thank you. Anyway, today I'm going to talk about Beyond Season 2, the Freeform show. Was it Hulu? No, it's Freeform. Anyway, I really enjoyed the second season, especially the second half of the season. The first half was rocky on the tense that you didn't know what was really happening because Holden was practicing his abilities but didn't want to use them, but he had nightmares. They made him use it towards the end. Got Willa, who was all about Holden helping her and Arthur the first season. The whole first season, this season, she was basically on some, let's forget about that other world, the dream state, whatever it's called. Then you got Luke, who's basically doing the typical thing where when you fall for your homie or your brother's girlfriend, you push away your brother so it hurts less when you basically pull a knife and stab him in the back. Because that's basically what he was doing. He was finding stupid reasons to be mad at Holden, which I was like, come on, Jeff. Luke, come on, man. Just own up to your feelings. He ended up doing it, but he went so far as to be in a boiling point with his brother, which I didn't like. But it was understandable, it was realistic, because that's what people do. Then we got Jeff being the step uncle. That's his step uncle, because he was kind of like the dad of the kid. Strong, like, yo. It was nice to see Jeff have his own part of this thing, not just be caught in Holden's mess. Like, Holden's mess had to be linked to his life this time, like very linked to his life. Even season one, kind of his brother, but it was more like Holden's story, and his brother put himself in a mess and he wanted to avenge his brother, but this time he was just trying to live and trouble found him, in a sense, you know what I'm saying. Then we got the man in the yellow jacket. It was cute to see him with his daughter interact. Still don't know the dude's name, but he's intriguing. I love that when that woman wanted him to die, she was like, bury him with that jacket. That was priceless, like the thief was just gonna keep the jacket. Also his mentor moment, that moment was badass, I won't lie. When they were just sitting down having a decent conversation, then they went ham at each other. Fight choreographing in this show is fantastic. Maybe it's because, you know, the camera frame and the cutting, the editing makes it precise and it's amazing. Then you got Arthur losing his shit. I think he's gonna have a bigger part in third season if the show gets renewed. I hope it gets renewed. At first half I probably would have been like, yo, they lost their mojo, but from episode five, end of five to 10, yo, the show was fire. Then we got Charlie. I really like Charlie. And Charlie and Holden dynamic. I really like the Charlie and Holden dynamic. Like, I feel like Charlie and Holden, same as Willa and Luke, they seem to fit better. You know what I'm saying? And they were about to make that official. Like, Holden and Willa are about to call it quits. Then Willa got kidnapped. It made me go, whoa. Did not see that coming, but I hope it's not one of those instances where they left the show with the extreme cliffhanger, then they cancel it, then they leave us with so many unanswered questions. Then they do some public release thing on how the season was supposed to continue, and I ain't reading that shit. But yeah, this season is amazing towards the second half. Let me just put it on straight. I give the season decent 7 out of 10, because the first half was too rocky for my liking. If it was constant, I would have given it an 8, but you know, it did have its little flaws. Like, I hate it when shows when somebody's got abilities or somebody's hiding something and there's still ignorant people involved, especially when it's in the second or third season or fourth season and there's still people that don't know, like Lucifer. It's detective still doesn't know he's the devil. Like, they have to change that dynamic for once, because she's too close to his personal life not to know right now. The fact that everybody knows, it's like everybody in the precinct is out of the loop. But now I'm going off topic, but Holden and Luke's parents this season were more intriguing, because, you know, they were taking action. They were just, it wasn't just family squabble, a whole divorce situation. This time they were teaming up, working together, and his father was so protective. And his father did that typical, you know, father mistake, trying to help out your son, trying to think better of him, but you low-key making his life miserable by trying to help him. I know that stuff happens. It happens in my family. It happens in a lot of people's family. So it was good. This season was more realistic. It was nice to see. You know what I'm saying? I really enjoyed the season. Like I said, 7 out of 10. Yeah.